years through this community of practice exercise. I think what Paulo Freire says, we have to unlearn in order to become effective teachers. We have to keep unlearning and keep forgetting how much we have to unlearn. And when we get beyond 50, then we think, you know, we hope that maybe that process is over, and then we discover it's actually more to learn, which is hellish. But there it is. And I think one of my big unlearnings is, and still an area of unlearning, is really to understand how competitive, how my colonial education has made me competitive. So even when I get into an NGO, I want to be the best damn NGO in the world. And I'm afraid to tell you too much about what my NGO is doing, in case yours gets a little better, and then maybe the funders like you more than me. I'm just putting it out there pretty crassly. But I have to say that was where I was, you know, and I think that is part of my social woundedness, probably. This kind of notion that I've got to survive in this crazy educational world. I've developed oppositional feelings towards the Western Cape Education Department, you know, because they don't do their work and they don't understand what we're trying to do, and I don't engage them. I don't actually find a forum for engagement. I'd rather just sit in the safe space of my office with enough like-minded, frustrated NGO specialists around me, and, you know, shake them down as much as we can. And when we began Bridge after the ANC Roadmap Conference, which was hosted by the DBSA, the word that was used in that conference constantly was the word innovation. And nobody really understood or had a view on that to say, we think innovation is this or that, this is what we should do. It's just like, we need innovation. And we were just burying, you know, curriculum, years of spending work on outcomes-based curriculum. And yet we were back to saying what we need is innovation. And so we went away from that conference and looked, got a group of people together and said, what do we really understand by innovation? It was interesting that what we came up with in our own South African context is that we do not understand scaling. We do not understand how to take a good idea and make it big. That we've got what Dr. Ambela keeps referring to as boutiques of excellence. Little narrow boutiques where we trumpet our stories and the narratives are great and very exciting, but actually the impact is so local that it is valuable only in that context and serves not as any kind of model for systemic change or as a contributor to any intent systemic change. And then I think back to my days in the Western Cape Education Department as an educator, how hard I worked in that space on good ideas and how they lost because I didn't know how to share them. I didn't even know how to claim them, actually. I always thought I was working somehow despite, rather than put that into the space as something that is worth doing. So the idea of creating a bridge between the ideas and the implementation, or between the boutique and the systemic shift, is what Bridge is really about. And so the Community of Practice Forum, bringing people together, is the first vehicle for that. And the surprise of my own feelings, having been part of initiating that, when we sat down together and realizing how little I knew about what others are doing, and yet I stood with these competitive beings. I don't even know what ASIC. I didn't know ASIC. I didn't know they give bursaries to young people. And yet I've got children leaving a school here who need bursaries. And where was I to find that information? I just stumbled on it somehow. And so within the Bridge framework, we say, let's keep open communities of practice together, and let's engage, but let's not make them NGO communities of practice or public sector communities of practice. Let's start to cross over and let's look for ways of actually beginning the discourse. My final personal part of that is when we met with members of Western Cape Education Department in what wasn't a great meeting last year, I had to take ownership of the fact that I had not at any stage with the various people in the room declared what we do to the Western Cape Education Department. And yet I was resentful of the fact that they didn't actually support us. And when the Western Cape Education Department voice on that particular occasion said to us, "So I didn't expect to see you again. I didn't know who was going to be in the room. I don't even know that you existed." I couldn't blame her for that. We had to look at ourselves, and we did that. We had to look at ourselves and say, what is it about us? What is it about us that we haven't put together a voice, that we haven't even articulated a group feel to intervention work that we're all doing with passion, and yet somehow we're doing it blind to what others are doing. So I'm just bringing that into the room so that we can really understand that we're still, in a sense, this meeting is a breakthrough meeting. Because I think for the first time we are engaging formally. And Glenn, thank you for making the obvious so obvious to us. Because you came, you know, into that meeting and helped us to see that actually it's just about saying, let's engage. And let's not be worried about the power or the politics of what engagement, how it's perceived. Let's just engage. Which is after all what we're trying to teach our children to. I'm going to give two people, if there are, just an opportunity to add any personal account to what Jennifer and I have brought into the room, to add anything that you think we may have missed or that would add strength to anything that